The Spirit of Detroit.
Yeah, good. Wishing I could wrap my whole life up in 24 karats of gold. Lately I've been dreaming about diamonds and pearls. Yep, diamonds and pearls. And enough money I could rule the world.
I am the stone that the builder refused. I am the visual, the inspiration that made ladies sing the blues. I'm the spark that makes your idea bright. The same spark that lights the dark so that you can know your left from your right. I am the ballad in your box, the bullet in the gun, the inner glow that let you know to call your brother son. The story that just begun, the promise of what's to come. And I'ma remain a soldier till the war is won. Won.
YouTube! What's going on? Welcome to Spirit of Detroit Podcast, and I'm your host, Avery Giovanni, wishing you a happy weekend, happy day, everything. Like, comment, subscribe for more thought-provoking content like this. And let's get into it, man. The Okwara brothers. You have your Watts on the Pittsburgh Steelers. You have your McCourties on the Patriots. And you have Shaquem and Shaquille Griffin, who played together for 2 years, 3 years for Seattle Seahawks. The Detroit Lions right now have two brothers that potentially could be a force in the league for years. Trust me, years. Julian and Romeo Okwara. Julian, the younger brother, I'm going to focus on him first. Julian is probably the more talented brother of the two. He has superior length, ability, speed, twitch, all that. His ability as an outside linebacker in speed and space, his ability with the dip, bull rush, and the swim move, second to none. He has the burst and the bend of a perfect 3-4 linebacker. Julian Okwara is probably weak against the run, a little more soft against the run, but if he put on 10 to 20 more pounds, he would have been probably the best guy against the run in college. Going back, I had to really deep dive into Julian Okwara's like attributes, because he was a third round pick 2020. Him being a third round pick, I had to ask myself why. 2019, he suffered the fibula, he broke his fibula. But he had first step explosiveness, he had pass rush counters, he had flexibility, he had hand technique, he was a force on Notre Dame, a constant force. He was rated before he got injured as a late first round pick. Early second pick. He shouldn't even be on his team. This is a quote from Draft Profile Network on his pass rush counters. His rip and dip is where he's going to win the most. Fortunately, he's quite polished there. His power combinations are sorely lacking, but his speed and rush moves are something to be revered. Flashes inside counter to work back inside with varying success. Thrives on surface production and speed and bend off the edge. Preferably speed in space pass rusher. I'm done, bro. I'm literally done. I've been saying speed in space is the way to go since the fucking new regime got here. I've been saying that the 3-4 classic edge rusher, the 6-4 classic edge rusher who runs a 4-5, 4-6 needs to be speed in space. And look at that. Look at that. Julian's worst thing is his strength against the run. Now, he didn't have an effective 2020. He barely saw the field. He was injured. When he was on the field, to me, non-factor. You know, it was terrible. But we have his brother. And probably drafting him is what kept us with his brother. Romeo Okwara is the fourth highest pressure player in the NFL. The fourth highest. This is who's in front of him. TJ Watt. Joey Bosa. Nick Bosa. That's who's in front of him. And we have them both. Matter of fact, Romeo Okwara is the less talented brother. Coming out of draft, he was supposed to be undrafted. He was a 6th-round pick for the New York Giants. And he wasn't even revered there. They had him for 2 years, cut him. Practice squad player, middle of the pack, got picked up by Detroit. And now he is the fourth highest, has the fourth highest pressure rate in the NFL. This is going to be special. We have the talent, the ability, the scheme for these two to flourish. Acquire and acquire. And this is for years to come. Putting on Quar, avoiding his contract earlier this year and giving him a real contract. Not a franchise, not some 1 year, $18 million. We gave him a real contract moving forward. Him and his brother are going to cause havoc moving forward. Now, Trey Flowers, I just did a video on Trey Flowers. I loved it. I thought it was great. But he is not a long-term answer, not a long-term solution. At the end of the day, I'm looking at the facts. I'm looking at the understanding. The Okwara brothers going to be monsters for years to come. Menaces to society. Like Riley and Huey in the fucking, the little cartoon that came, the Boondocks. If Julian Okwara improves his consistency overall and his athleticism meets his production, it's over with. You have the highest pressure rate in the league. It's over with. We could talk about Ozarike. We could talk about McNeil. We could talk about the secondary. But at the end of the day, if these two do their job on the outside, it's over with. Because you can only chip block with the tight end so much. You can only chip block in a 2-shotgun formation so much, Aaron Rodgers. You can only swing the left tackle this way. You can only swing the pressure protection this way so many times a game. Because if Julian is the key to this. Because I know Romeo going to give me that work. Romeo putting up 7-8 sacks a year. Has the most pressure rate. His pressure rate, we couldn't even find nobody else on the defense to have a pressure rate just like him. And these boys are smart. They don't just sack the quarterback. They go after that ball. With Aaron Glenn at the helm, Don Capers at the helm, I feel more confident in our outside linebackers than I do in our whole defense. That's why linebacker is not a weakness to me. If we're talking about pass rushers, we have B-plus ability right now. We have Trey Flowers, who gave you 7 sacks his first year. And he was playing optimal time. He was playing optimal snaps standing up, optimal snaps. He was back and forth. He was on the line. He was standing up in space, giving you production. But to have Julian and Romeo Okwara, even if Austin Bryant is hurt, we don't need you, guy. We good. We straight. I'm liking this. I'm liking this a lot. More production I expect more production out of the outside linebacker than production with the inside linebacker. If middle linebacker is our weakness, I'm okay with that. But you have a front four or five. That's what you know. We do not deserve Romeo Okwara, and him staying here in Detroit is meaningful to me. 26-year-old, 27-year-old man, got that big contract. I don't think he falls off. I don't. Julian, athletic freak, had a year to heal, has an exceptional offseason, a usual offseason, putting in extra work, younger player. It's going to be amazing. I don't understand the run defending to me is going to be fixed with the Michael Brockers acquisition. The run defending disregard and disrespect to me is not warranted. I mean, he was a player that came out 6.3, very high, you know, late first round pick. And if you were talking about run defending, that's not why he's there. In an effective 3-4, he is a pass rusher. He is a Clay Matthews. If he needs to clean up the edge and all that other stuff and play contain on the run, okay. But your defensive line is a two-gap defensive line. Your defensive line needs to be the defensive line so he can clean it up. And I don't think I've seen that in the film. Julian should honestly get 5 sacks this year. And I would be happy with that production. Because to me, this is a rookie year for him. Romeo, clean it up. Get 8-9 sacks. Because he's a pressure player. At the end of the day, these two brothers could be very special for us. And I'm inclined to say that I can't wait to see it. My name is Avery Giovanni. This is Spirit of Detroit Podcast. Like, comment, subscribe. Love y'all.